Hi, in this video, let's discuss about the general form of using induction on integers. Here, we are given several bases, not just one basis as we have seen in the last example. We have si, si plus 1, etc. up to s of j for some j greater than I. We prove all these base statements are true. And then we will assume from s of I plus 1, etc. till s of n for n greater than or equal to j is true. And using this, we will conclude, that is from s of I plus 1, etc. up to s of n plus 1. All together will conclude s of n plus 1. Let's see an example. If n is greater than or equal to 8, then n can be written as a sum of 3s and 5s. So, let's take the basis statements. So, the minimum value that n can assume is 8. So, s of 8, we can write 8 as 3 plus 5. And then we consider s of 9. And 9 can be written as 3 plus 3 plus 3. And there is no 5s here. So, 0 5s and 3 3s. So, that is why we include s of 9 and s of 10. We have 5 plus 5. 10 is equal to 5 plus 5. There is 0 3s and 2 5s. So, 8 if you consider, we have both 5, 1 3 and 1 5. Here only 3s and 0 5s. Here only 5s and 0 3s. So, that's why we have 3 basis statements here. In the hypothesis, we will assume for any n greater than or equal to 10, s of 8, s of 9 till s of n. We have to prove now s of n plus 1. That is, n plus 1, we should be able to write it as some factors of 3 plus some factors of 5. So, n plus 1 will just subtract 3 from this. So, when we subtract 3 from n plus 1, we get n minus 2. And from the hypothesis, we know that s of n minus 2 is true. Because in the hypothesis, we have assumed till s of n is true. So, s of n minus 2, we should be able to write it as some a times 3 plus some b times 5. So, this n plus 1 is nothing but n minus 2 plus 3. It is just one more 3 than n minus 2. So, s of n plus 1, we can write it as a plus 1 times 3 plus b times 5. Thereby, we will be able to write s of n plus, or n plus 1 as some factor of 3 plus some factor of 5. And thereby we have proved for any n greater than or equal to 8, then n can be written as the sum of 3s and 5s. In the next video, I will discuss about proof by deduction. And thank you for watching the video.